Hello, guys.
And welcome back to BTV.
We've got some good stories for you today, Beavers.
Have you heard of NaNoWriMo?
No, what's NaNoWriMo?
It stands for National Novel Writing Month.
Fiona and Corey have the story.
This week on the Fiona and Corey Project, we're talking about NaNoWriMo.
Yes, you heard that right. NaNoWriMo, or National Novel Writing Month.
NaNoWriMo is a contest that happens every year in November, where the participants attempt to write a 50,000-word-long novel that's about this long.
Yes, and they have to finish it by midnight, November 30th.
But what's it about? You can pick. It can be about mermaids on a space exploration.
Sherlock Holmes on the moon.
Or even David Bowie.
Yay! They even have a fancy website and everything. So who in BHS crazy enough to do this?
Molly Thibodeau! You crazy girl, trying to attempt the whole 160 pages? What are you, a wizard?
Yes.
Well, make yourself at home while we get things ready.
Oh.
Cool. Hot cocoa.
Yes. Awesome. I wonder where this came from.
I wouldn't know.
Well, Molly, what inspired you to try for this challenge? It seems pretty hard to keep up with school, and you do drama, right? And piano. Why is NaNoWriMo important enough for you to try to do it?
Well, I don't know. I just always really liked writing stories, and I just like making up my own characters and stuff. And I think if I stopped doing that and let everything else get in the way of writing, then I would lose that. And NaNoWriMo kind of forces you to write, so it's not something that I can really escape, which is good.
That's really cool. So how's it been so far? What's the funnest?
Most fun.
Funnest part of writing?
It's not really that fun, actually. It actually really sucks. It's a lot of staying up too late and hating yourself and hating your writing and just feeling like poop. But I mean, it's fun in that you get to share that experience with other people who actually do love to write at least a little bit.
Well, that's good. Are you able to give us a brief synopsis of your book, or is it top secret?
It's about dead people, and death, and ghosts, and blood, and murder. Lots of murder. Like, 5 people have died.
Is there love?
No. I mean, there's a little bit, but it's not, no, love's boring. I think the two lovers both die, so.
Well, thank you so much for this interview.
Yeah, no problem.
See you.
On a handshake. Yeah. Now leave.
Bye.
Well, that was great.
See you in school.
Well, that was great. To close up, I thought I ought to write my own story. Not quite the masterpiece of a novel, but here it goes. It's my story. Once upon a time, our moon-dwelling friend Sherlock Holmes was bored. Quite bored. Dr. Watson, his flat-sharing companion, was out to get some space milk. Sherlock had no one to bother, or cases to solve. Bored, he muttered. Then, with absolutely no warning, a rocket ship crash-landed into his Moononian flat. What the devil? Sherlock was quickly cut off, because suddenly the hatch began to lower. Steam cascaded slowly from the opening, and a silhouette shone. As the steam settled, his face came into view, and a one David mother-freaking Bowie emerged. Our beacon of space pop. Hello, David said. I've come on a money moon with me beloved Martha. Martha came out, and her lower half was entombed in a mobile aquarium. She was a mermaid. We're exploring space. Sherlock, shocked because his only one idol was in front of him right now. David Bowie! It's been a dream of mine ever since I was a kid to rock out with you! David agreed immediately to rock out, and the two of them rocked out, hardcore, to changes and life on Mars while Martha stood by. Then Watson came home. To be continued?
That was really good. Maybe you could make a full-length novel out of that.
You know, I was actually thinking about making a movie or, like, maybe some sort of TV series.
Well, that's all we have time for.
All right. Well, bye!
Thanks, girls, for that information on NaNoWriMo.
Hey, Nick, isn't senior year great?
It is, but it's actually very stressful.
Steph has the inside scoop on how seniors are doing.
knowing that next year I'll have to go to college is kind of scary.
What scares me most about senior year is probably leaving everybody that I know. And, like, going away from all my friends or them leaving me.
What scares me the most about senior year is just that we're getting closer to college and all the workload that's coming up after that. Well, it's mostly just like the scholarship, applying for scholarships and stuff that's taking really long, and then a lot of essays, and it's just not fun.
Yeah, I've applied to a couple colleges and still waiting back, or waiting here back.
I've started some applications. It's just really confusing just getting all that paperwork together and making sure everything looks really good for those applications. And it's something that you really need to be careful with and just spend time on them and don't just rush them. Right now is not knowing whether or not I'll be able to pay for 4 years of college because it gets pretty expensive.
Just getting the right amount of money for scholarships and going to the right place. Going to like the CCC or whatever has helped me a lot, and just talking to all the people and applying to a bunch of colleges, looking for all the different scholarships to help me out.
Again, just hoping I get accepted into the college that I want to and just being successful. Don't procrastinate. That's really, really important because maybe you don't think that if you got freshman year was really important, but come senior year, you realize that it all comes back to you. So it's really important that you work really hard, do all your work, and not procrastinate. Start junior year looking for like colleges and scholarships and get like an Aspire counselor because they really help a lot.
I don't know, just do as many classes as you can early, so senior year is going to be really easy. And just have fun with it. Don't take it too seriously and stress out.
Next up, we have a package about Beaverton's water polo team.
Let's see what they've been up to.
So we heard you traveled to California. How do you think that helped your team?
The boys team got to travel to California this year, and they experienced a very high level of play, and I think it caused them to get tough. I think it caused them to really understand how difficult the game is, how physical it is, and I think we also got some good conditioning because it was double deep pools.
In your perspective, what do you think qualifies a water polo player to want to play water polo?
I think the game is a combination of endurance, agility, it's physical game. It's an opportunity. The water is a great equalizer, so it allows all different types of people and all different types of experience to play the game. So I think what draws people to it is it's something new and something different that they haven't been exposed to their whole life in most cases.
What mostly do you guys do at your practices to help you in your games?
Well, we do a fair amount of conditioning, as you can see, or maybe here in the background, we're getting ready to do some more conditioning, but a lot of fundamental ball skills. This game is really a lot of times about one-on-one matchups, so it's being able to handle the ball, play one-on-one defense, one-on-one offense. That's really the key fundamentals in the game that you have to be successful.
Thank you, Coach, for your time.
You're welcome.
My sister played the sport, and I played it before in other settings, and I just thought it was a really fun sport, and I wanted to continue playing.
I chose to do water polo because it's good exercise, and I wanted to make new friends.
It's kind of a family tradition. My dad played it, his brother, and now I got put into it.
We have a really close relationship, and we're all really good friends.
It's really a family relationship. You know, we really get to know these guys. Got to know them over several years. I'm good friends with them. You know, they're my main friends in high school, and it's a really tight knit community. We support each other, and it's just a great time. It's very close.
We're all pretty good friends. I'm gonna miss all the seniors that are leaving now. Sorry. Bond with the team, get better, practice hard.
Shoot the ball.
My favorite thing to do in practice is play pairs. Pairs is basically water polo without rules. So it's very fun. You get to drown people, and it's a lot of fun.
You get to drown people. Is that safe?
No.
Well, let's see.
Thanks, video journalism.
You guys are doing great.
How are you liking No School November?
It's my favorite month of the year, Nicholas.
Speaking about days off and other school events, here are the announcements. Now you're gone.
Thanksgiving break goes from November 21st through the 25th. Perspectives Week is the 26th through the 30th. On November 30th, we have the Diversity Assembly, and right after that, the Senior Class Picture of 2013. There's no school on December 3rd, so enjoy your day off, Beavers!
Thanks for watching another episode of BTV.
Have a great Thanksgiving.
Another crazy story, come on, see.
I was hanging at the court, just playing some ball, working on my game.
Yeah, we heard it all.
I heard the fans screaming, I thought it was for me. But then I saw a shadow, it was 12 for 3. It was Shaquille O'Neal.